Once upon a time, far away to the south, a girl sat on a lawn plaiting her hair. It was a perfect summer's day, with only the merest hint of a breeze in the air. But the young girl was not happy. She was going away to the north to stay with her grandparents. Not because she wanted to, but because she always did at this time of the year. And because she was bored. Nothing ever happened here. No excitement. No romance. Nothing.
Anne! We'll be late!
Except in books.
Mrs. Green!
Hello, Anne. Someone's in a hurry.
Off to see my grandparents, up north. Yorkshire pudding, you buy gum, you know. Has he come?
I'll have a look. Here it is.
Great! Put it on Mum's account. Bye, Mrs. Green.
Make sure you behave yourself.
I'm a little girl looking for a little boy. I only want me one. Just a girl who's looking for love. Who don't want a love, who just wants enough. Just a little girl looking for a little boy. We can have some fun. But I'm looking everywhere. And I can't find it here. I can't find it there.
Almost a stranger.
She closed her eyes. She couldn't believe what was happening. But there was the bell. As in a dream, she went through the small hallway and opened the door. "You'd better not come in," she stuttered. But without a word, he stepped inside, almost as if he owned the place, his aromatic cologne mixing uneasily with her own cheap scent. From that moment on, she knew he would possess her. What if I wrote a story and was in it at the same time? Then I could make things happen. Let's see. Anne was a young and very beautiful. No. Unusually attractive girl.
Go on.
Was I speaking aloud? Sorry.
I was enjoying it. I like your stories. When you were quite a little girl...
Granny.
Grindel and I are going to the garden centre. Would you like to come?
No, thank you. I might go for a walk.
Well, you know where the park is. And you are a very beautiful young girl.
Don't be silly, Granny. Anne was a young and unusually attractive girl. Once a year, she went to stay with her grandparents, who lived in a beautiful old house on the edge of a large, sprawling industrial town, far away to the north. Normally, on her first day, she would go to the park and watch the ducks on the pond. But this morning, she felt like exploring. And so, the search began in earnest. Somewhere in one of these quaint little houses, he was waiting for her, even watching her, now at this moment.
Look what you've done.
Oh, I am sorry.
Clumsy idiot.
Moment.
Come in. What for?
To have a look.
You're from social services, aren't you?
No.
Oh. After me money, eh? One of them muggers.
I'm a girl.
Makes no odds.
If I wanted to steal money, I wouldn't have given your purse back, would I?
All right. Just a quick look, mind.
Isn't it sweet? Got a video.
Didn't steal it. It's on prescription for me depressions. Not having them.
Penny dreadfuls, aren't they? They sell them in our village, in an antique shop. What's
wants the tea?
Brief encounter. Celia Johnson and...
Trevor Howard.
How do you know that?
It's my mother's favourite film.
Oh.
It makes her cry.
Oh, aye.
Me too, sometimes. Well, thanks for letting me look.
Want a cup of tea?
All right. Thank you.
Well, shut bloody door then and put kettle on.
You like love stories then?
Aye. So long as boy meets girl, I'm happy.
Or girl meets boy?
Wish folk could rewind.
Remote control, eh?
I'm all right. Go away.
It's me, Gran. Ralph.
Oh. Come in, then.
The door opened and a tall, dark stranger entered. His eyes searched the room hungrily and met hers.
Who's that?
Gillian or Annabel or somewhat.
Anne.
She a social worker? I'm churchy. Who is she, Gran?
The girl with the golden eyes.
Gran.
Well, how should I know?
I'm Anne Thompson. I'm staying with my grandparents in Roundhay. But I live in Sussex.
And she knocked me over and asked to sell in for tea.
Oh, aye. Shall I?
Oh, she's all right. She likes love stories.
She's my gran. Granny wife. Mm-hmm. So don't mess with her around. Goodbye, gran.
Goodbye.
He's a good lad. Well, you'd best go now, love. I need me nap before I watch film. They shatter me.
Shall I make a fire for you?
Can't afford fire, love. It's summer.
Bye, then.
She couldn't get him out of her mind. The strange boy from the north. The full, inviting lips. The soft, appealing eyes. She lay awake, imagining his body next to hers.
Good night, Anne, dear. Nice to have you with us.
Night, night, Grindel.
Sweet dreams.
Been shopping?
Oh, it's you.
Special offer, eh?
Well, you could help.
Aye, good.
Well, at least find something to put this in.
Easy.
But that's not yours.
Council property, isn't it? My council, so it's my bag. Who's coal for?
Your granny.
Granny White? You've bought coal?
No. I borrowed it from my grandparents.
Granny White.
And you fooled there, eh, Ralph?
Aye. Found her outside again.
I've brought you some coal. And a tape. I thought you'd be cold.
Gran.
Well, thank you kindly, madam.
Hey, and to wish your aunt.
What's deep? A man and a woman. Ooh, sounds hopeful. Put it on for us, love. Here a minute. Here. That's better. Us girls have a good cry, eh?
Best be going. Try, Gran. Bye-bye, Lady Di.
I'd better go.
What about film?
I've seen this one. Bye.
Ralph. Ralph! Ralph!
it's you. What are you doing here?
I thought you might like to go for a walk.
You've got a taxi? To ask me? Bloody hell.
Well, will you?
This guy's supposed to be mad in love with me. Anne smiled at him seductively, enticingly, willing him to come with her.
What's up?
Something in my eye. Could you look?
Can't see now.
Are you sure?
Aye, there might be a bit in the corner.
That's better. Thanks.
That's where I'm going if you want to come.
Why do you come here?
It's peaceful. I like paintings.
I think they're boring.
You don't have to stay.
Felt a little uneasy. He wasn't the normal sort of tall, dark stranger. He didn't shower his lady with words of love and passion. Still, she would persist. Stories take time.
Close your eyes.
What am I looking for?
This.
The long gallery, yes.
Well, what do you think?
Seem better.
How? They used to exercise dogs here when it was raining.
What?
Don't matter.
Fancy swap?
What you got?
Madonna. Duran Duran. How about you?
Helga.
Helga? Never heard of them. They're local band.
Helga, the composer. You know. Land of dope and tourists.
Oh. I hate that.
Well, this isn't that. It's Enigma Variations. It's about all his mates. No lyrics, though. No. Your granddad's place like that?
Not much of a beat. She was in love now. She longed to reach out her hand and stroke his soft brown skin, to draw him close and feel his warm breath on her cheek, to hold him.
Raise it to bottom.
And be held by him.
Who are you? Now go away, you're trespassing. This is private property. I'll call the police.
Is that your...
My granny, yes.
It's all right, Granny. He's with me.
Hold on.
He's a friend of mine. I met him at the park.
Oh.
Can I bring him in for some lunch?
Well, I suppose so, yes, but...
Ralph, it's all right. He's gone.
Never mind. Lance rang earlier, asked if you'd like to play tennis this afternoon. That'd be fun, wouldn't it?
Now he had disappeared again, and she might never find him. A lump formed in her throat. A wave of sadness coursed through her veins. Poor little Anne was very unhappy, but she wouldn't cry.
Six low.
You all right, Anne? You haven't scored a point yet.
Just a bit out of practice. Should we do something else?
Sure, why not?
If only he would appear now, run onto the court, grab her hand and take her away from this...
Want a rub down?
Pudding.
No, thank you.
What was he doing now?
It's your go.
Anne tried to imagine her tall, dark stranger.
Anne? It's your go.
Sorry. He would gently touch her hair, softly brush her cheek. What are you doing?
Sorry. Don't you go in for that sort of thing?
I'm a lesbian.
Oh, I see.
Why had he run off like that? What was he frightened of? Perhaps it was because she was rich. Perhaps it was the way she spoke.
Night, night, Anne. Oh. Enjoying your stay?
Yes, thanks.
Good. Anne, dear, that coloured boy, the one in the garden.
Yes.
You will be careful, won't you?
What do you mean?
Well, some parts of town are a bit rough.
Granny, I'm 15. Anyway, I told you, I met him in the park. Granny, why are so many people poor?
Happiness is what counts, dear, no money. Sleep well.
She had to see Granny White again. She'd know where Ralph was.
Pop, rock, country, reggae, folk, blues, you name it, we got it.
No, Elgar.
Janice?
What?
We got anything by Elgar?
Oh.
Do you have a fridge?
What's all that for?
You?
Me?
So you don't starve.
Where'd you get it?
I bought it.
Lady Di, Lady Di, you'll break me heart, make me cry.
I'm not Lady Di. I'm Anne, Anne Thompson.
From sunny Sussex, I know, love. But I can't eat meat, Anne. It's my stomach, see?
Oh.
Ah, oh, come over here, love. If you're dead set on buying me summat, I could do with a new teapot.
Did you enjoy the film?
Oh, aye. I've watched it 3 times already.
I brought you another.
Oh. Prepare to die. Oh, a thriller, is it?
I expect so.
Put it on for us, love.
You haven't seen Ralph, have you?
No.
Oh. Does he live in those flats up the hill?
Shh.
One day we are all going to die. One day you are going to die. But when you're dead, what will happen to your money?
I ain't got none.
Will it be buried, just like you, lost forever in the deepest vaults of the tax barons?
Prepare to Die, a Daily Telegraph guide to ordering your tax affairs in preparation for death.
Lovely, Anne. And so light.
Granny White. Are you all right?
It's me hips playing me up, that's all.
Should I get a doctor?
No. I'm on waiting list.
For what?
Hip operation.
But if it hurts, why wait?
Because there's a queue, that's why.
Hello.
Hello.
What are you doing here?
Looking for you.
Oh.
Your granny's not well. Her hip.
I know. That's why I've come. To take her out. Get the old wheelchair out here, Granny.
Don't forget me book.
His eyes seemed warmer now, like the ice had begun to melt. The cold blueness had turned to a gentle brown. As he moved towards her, his mouth brushed her ear and whispered,
"Fancy coming too?"
"Come on, Anne, love. I'd like you to."
Oh, great.
Shall we both listen?
What about Gran?
As she felt the music flowing through her young body, she longed for his arms to reach out and hold her. If she kept her eyes closed for long enough, something was sure to happen. But it didn't. Do you really think I'm like Lady Di?
No. You're all right.
Why wouldn't he touch her? What was holding him back? She wondered what she could do to make him come closer. Look at those ducks over there.
Okay, Gran. We're going home.
Will I see you again?
Maybe.
When?
Tomorrow.
Will you come and pick me up?
Your Gran scares me.
It's all right. I'll keep a lookout. About 10. Okay. Suddenly, a plan began to form itself in her mind. A rather clever plan. How's the tennis?
It's fine.
And the backgammon?
I'm sorry about the other night.
It doesn't matter. I wanted to ask you something. You know about insurance, don't you?
A certain amount, yes.
Well, I'm writing a book.
About?
No. It's a thriller. Fancy bobbing for an apple?
If a bank was burgled, would... with the insurance, perhaps, straight away?
There'd be an investigation. Check there'd been no fraud. Genuine signs of a break-in.
And if they were satisfied?
They'd pay up.
In full?
Of course.
Great. Thanks.
Where are you going?
To write the next chapter. Writer's inspiration, you know. Keep bobbing. You're very good at it. You might win something.
Granny?
Yes, dear?
You know your arthritic hip?
Mm-hmm.
Did you have to wait a long time before they could put it right?
No, dear, they were very quick.
Was it expensive?
Extraordinary question, I've no idea. James? James?
Was I snoring?
How much did my hip operation cost?
Well, insurance paid, of course. Private room, about £3,000, I suppose.
There's a young coloured boy hanging around the back door. Should I?
Great.
Shouldn't bring him in if I were you. Your grandfather's a bit funny about strangers.
I can't.
Huh?
But why not?
One, not a burglar. And two, I might get caught.
You wouldn't. I'd let you in.
Maybe they're not as rich as they look.
Oh, well, they'd get the money back. Insurance. Please.
Oh, I don't know, Anne. It don't seem right. I mean, robbing your own grandparents.
Look, your granny needs an operation and decent heating and a lot of other things. We could sell the stuff and...
Why don't you do it?
Because someone's got to break in from the outside and I've got to be in bed when they find the stuff gone. And, well... it'll be no fun doing it by myself.
And how am I supposed to carry all this stuff?
I've picked out 10 items of value. They're quite small. They'll fit into a rucksack easily.
That's going to look great, that is. Walking along the streets at 3 o'clock in the morning, wearing a bloody great rucksack.
If the worst came to the worst and you got caught, I'd own up and say it was my fault and that I gave you the stuff.
They'd never believe you.
Of course they would. Come on, Ralph. It's to help your granny.
It doesn't seem right. I'll have to think on it. Hey, fancy coming out tonight?
That's no answer.
Great little band on.
Who?
Local, but good. I'll pick you up at Town Hall at 7.
What about the burglary? Coward.
Thank you.
great little band.
Well, it were local.
What now, then?
A couple of hours to the last bus.
Fancy a dance? You must know some good clubs.
Fancy a dance? I don't go dancing much.
Don't you? I thought all... So?
I know a good pub with a disco. Could try that.
Come on, then. Have you decided yet?
What?
About the burglary.
No.
I'm not coming, then.
Don't be daft. That's blackmail.
I think you're frightened.
Of course I'm not. It's a stupid idea, that's all.
No, you're just too scared to do it.
I'm not.
Too much Mozart's made you go soft. Night-night, Wolfgang. Hey, what are you doing? Ow!
Look, get one thing straight. It's not because I'm scared. Okay. Okay.
All right. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that.
I mean, why should I do it? You're going home. I'm stuck here. Suppose it all goes wrong?
It won't. It'll be an adventure. No risk. Like Robin Hood.
And Maid Marian. Sheriff of Nottingham's high tech now, you know.
Hal still rides a bike. I'll come dancing. You don't have to do it. It's just that I'd like you to.
If I did do it, would you come up and see me again?
Of course. And Granny White. Won't it be great when she can walk properly again?
Get in?
About midnight. Didn't you hear me?
You should have let us know you were going to be late.
Sorry.
You can make up for it by helping me prepare for the dinner party tonight.
Dinner party? Tonight?
I've asked the Roberts over.
You what?
You and Lance seem to be getting on so well at the fete.
Did we? Oh. Will they stay late?
No idea, why?
Just wondered. Fancy a dance, Lance?
Good film, isn't it?
What a shame. Tape must have run out. Never mind. Probably time for bed anyway.
I'm not tired.
Aren't you?
How's the book?
The book? Nearly finished. Very tiring work.
Anne? What do lesbians actually do?
Young enjoying themselves?
Yes, thank you, Mrs. Lewis.
Good. We can hang on for a bit if you want to.
No, no. Lance was just saying how tired he was. Weren't you, Lance?
What?
I'll get your coat.
Anne?
I didn't bring a coat, Mrs. Lewis.
Never mind, dear. you two. Time for Bedfordshire. Oh.
You took your time. I'm bloody freezing.
Sorry. Unexpected guests.
Who was that bloke?
A twit.
Clever, eh?
Fancy a drink?
Aye, all right. Come on then, let's load up.
Not yet. There's no hurry. Another drink.
Ralph. Ralph. It's morning. Ralph?
A cup of coffee?
No time. Grandfather gets up at 7. And Ralph, get rid of the stuff quick, won't you? You mustn't be found with it. And now the story was nearly finished. When they had sold the stuff and paid for Granny's hip, they would run away together and live happily ever after. Ralph and Anne. Anne and Ralph.
Anne, darling. Anne, dear. We've been burgled.
What? When?
Last night. There's not much gone.
What about the alarm?
Oh, Grindel must have forgotten to put it on. I didn't want to have to wake you, but the police are downstairs. They want to know the address of that coloured boy, the one who came round yesterday.
Why? He didn't do it. Anyway, I don't know.
His name, then?
Joe.
Joe. Apparently, a coloured youth was reported trying to sell a clock like ours earlier this morning. He'll need identifying when they bring him in.
No. This wasn't right. This wasn't in the story. Bring him in? What do you mean?
Well, they're, what do they call it, tailing him at the minute, to see if he tries to dump any more of the stuff.
Oh.
Come down when you're ready. The police would like a word.
Ralph, thank God!
What are you doing here?
Never mind. They're on to you.
What? Who's on to who? What's going on?
You tell her.
No, you do it.
It was your idea.
I gave some things to Ralph last night so that he could sell them and pay for you to have an operation.
What things.
Some of my grandparents.
Without them knowing.
She got me burgle house, Granny.
She what?
So the insurance would pay.
Is that the train?
It all went wrong. Is that the I'm sorry.
Go away. What are you doing here?
He didn't do it.
Shut up, Anne.
It was all my fault. I put him up to it.
You try and sell this morning.
He didn't steal it. I gave it to him. It was my fault.
You're Anne Thompson, I presume?
Yes, look.
Your grandparents will be down to pick you up.
Come along, you.
You bastard!
Why can't you understand? It was my fault. Leave me alone.
Listen, love. Three bits of advice. One, don't make up silly stories to try and save your friends. Two, stick to your own kind. And three, don't mix with coloureds. It ain't worth it, love.
Horrible boy. What did he make you do?
Nothing, Granny. Nothing. It was me. I made him do it.
Come on, dear. No time for stories now.
I know. No time for stories. I'll find my own way back.
Anne!
Anne!
just a girl who's looking for love, who don't want to love, who just wants to know.